Welcome back to the video series about proper handling of harvested game. Now that you've got your carcass prepared and deboned, you're ready to package and put it in your freezer. You'll need from cutting to grinding and finally packaging. So your tools for cutting are gloves to keep your hands and the meat clean, cutting boards, sharp knives, steel to keep the edge on your knives, and a meat tub. And if you like ground venison, there's a lot of inexpensive grinders out there. In addition to your meat tub, now you're ready to start grinding. And once you've got your meat cut the way you want, there's a variety of options for packaging. And we'll show you the three most common: vacuum sealers, freezer paper, and freezer bags. Great, so now we've got our deboned meat. We're ready to start final trim prior to packaging the meat. The first thing we wanna do, in this example, we're gonna use the loin. Or our back straps, and we want to remove any of this external fat that's still remaining on here that we left from the deboning process, as well as this heavy membrane or silver skin along the back. It's going to be much more tender and enjoyable if we do remove those pieces. We'll start simply, we have a lot of this external part. It's not even really the loin muscle, but there's a lot of fat involved. We do want to remove that along with some of that silver skin. Most of that really is not even worth. We have a small piece here we can add to trimmings. The rest of this really needs to go to scrap. So once we've got most of the external fat off, there's a little here that we can cut off. The rest will come off during the removal of this silver skin. So here you can see we've got the rounded portion. On this side, it's a bit more flat. Right here's our edge of the silver skin, and this is what we want to start. This is a location that for me, it's best to start. And I take a chunk right off of the corner is the way I prefer to do it. And that'll give you a very good starting place for the rest. The connective tissue here is extremely heavy, and it's easiest to just simply get that out of the way. Now we've got a nice strip in the middle that we're essentially going to, just like filleting a fish, removing the skin, we're going to remove this silver skin. So I like to simply get the point of the knife underneath, and just by making some small cuts, you'll get it loosened up. So once we get it loosened, we can really just start to peel away from the skin, from the muscle. And it's seldom going to come off in one single piece, but we want to be peeling it off, and you can see I've left no meat on the skin. We have a very good separation between meat and skin. It peels off extremely easy if you have a sharp knife. Don't be concerned if the first couple times you do this, it's not quite as clean. But as we peel, we get that removed. Be aware of the direction of your knife blade. You don't ever want to cut your arms or your hands. But we simply get that removed. Small pieces like this, I wouldn't worry about, and for purposes of the video here, I will go ahead and remove it. So what we'll do with this loin, I'll show you the back half. We're going to make a roast. Make it as big as you prefer. I like somewhere here around 8-10 inches. Just a simple cut right along the length. Here you've got an excellent roast, a little bit bigger than your tenderloins would be. Going to be a fantastic piece of a roast. For the second part, we're going to start making slices for chops. My personal preference is to make a chop that's somewhere around 3/8 to 1/2 inch. Those cook very nice. They're very tender. They're very easy to cook. And just make simple straight cuts perpendicular to the length of the loin. And we can make our chops ready to go. So the next piece we want to work on after finishing the loin, I want to demonstrate the knuckle or the quadriceps muscle that you saw in the deboning video we removed from the front part of the hind leg or the ham. Just like on the loin, the main goal here is to remove the silver skin and any external fat that you may see. Primarily it's going to be some underneath here, but really this is a clean piece, and then we'll demonstrate the slicing, how we do wish to slice it across the grain. So once we have our piece of meat trimmed and clean
Again, it's time to slice. As I mentioned, we want to slice across the grain. With this piece, if you think of it shaped like a football, you just put it end to end and slice from one end to the next. In this piece, you can use your same knife you have been. I personally like to use a larger knife because it's a larger piece, and again, that allows me to make one nice, even cut. I like to, as I said before, go about 3/8 of an inch, make a nice, simple, straight cut. There's our nice steak, excellent piece of meat. And you can see, you've probably seen beef that looks like this, your beef tips. You'll see the multiple muscles in there. Really beautiful piece, low fat, great eating quality. So we've demonstrated the trimming and slicing process for some of the more choice cuts of meat. Here we just have a simple piece of trim that's going to go in our bucket for grinding at a later date. But it's the same process. We want to remove this external fat. If there is any heavy connective tissue, it also needs to be removed. So for trimming, as we mentioned, it's just simple finding this external fat, getting it removed, especially the heavy, harder fats from the surface. You can really just peel that right off, removing it as much as possible. Additionally, I like to look at if there's some of this loose membrane that we can get off. Sometimes it's not a bad thing, but it's not a necessity. And there's a little bit of the silver skin membrane trim here. It really depends on how detailed you want to be, if you want to remove this level of covering or if you want to leave it into your grind. Personally, I prefer having as much fat removed as I can just for a higher quality product, but it's certainly okay if you prefer to leave that on there. At this point, you know, this piece was pretty clean to start with. You want to be sure you look at both sides. There can always be something hiding underneath that you did miss. We'll cut it off. And at this point, I say this piece is ready to go directly to our grinder. So here you can see our meat finished trimming, ready to be ground. You'll notice there's a very little amount of fat here. It does take a bit more time and work on your part, but you're going to be much more satisfied with the product at the end if you'll just put a little bit of time up front into it. So the first method of packaging our meat that we're going to demonstrate is a very simple but popular method of using freezer paper and wrapping it. The first thing obviously you need to do is to cut your freezer paper to your desired length or width. I like to have a square roughly as long and as wide as a freezer paper. Once that's done, keep your wax side up. We'll place the meat on, fold it, wrap it, tape it. Once you label it, you're finished. So the first packaging method we're going to demonstrate is the use of freezer paper. Very simple. We're going to demonstrate this with one of our loin roasts. I like to lay it on the package a little bit crossways and go from corner to corner with our wrap. Get one good wrap on there. At this point, you can fold your edges in. Then continue to wrap around. You can keep folding your edges in if there are some. When it comes around, have a very nice single piece of tape. Be sure you're using freezer tape, as a standard masking tape won't work at this point. I then like to be sure that we're labeling what we have in here. In this case, we have loin roast. And I like to be sure to label the date so that we know when this animal was harvested and packaged. And in this case, November 20th in 2016. And here we have our packaged roast ready to go into the freezer. The second method we're going to demonstrate is the basic use of a freezer bag. In this case, we're going to put in some steaks. I like to put in about 4 steaks. It's one of the simplest methods we have. We simply put in the meat, package it as flat as possible and nice so it's nice when it comes out. I like to be sure I'm mashing out as much air as possible. That will keep your product a little longer. Simple zip, and it is ready. Be sure you are using freezer bags, not basic storage bags. And let's be sure that we label our product. In this case, we have tip steaks. And again, be sure we're putting the date on here. In this case, November 20th, 2016. At this point, ready to go into the freezer. So the last process that we're going to show you is the use of vacuum sealing. In this case, we will seal a single loin roast. Feel free to put two or three roasts in the bag, whatever fits your bag and your size of your family. Once you have the product in the bag, you simply place it into the vacuum sealer, press and hold until you've vacuumed and sealed, label your meat, and you're ready to freeze.
If you followed us all the way through this video series, you now have the basics of processing your harvest from field to fork.